Hello and welcome back to Cautionary Global Financial Analysis. Today we're looking at the global beverage industry as of interim 2020, although as noted here, FMX data is actually to fiscal year end as of December 2019 and DEOs to fiscal year end June 2020. So they're not exactly the same time period. If we begin with the first with the three companies, Diageo DEO, Fomento Economico Mexicano, FMX, and Coca Cola, KO. There are five metrics in total. The first two are in a range from 0 to 1, or alternatively 0 to 100%. And the last three are in terms of cash flow to revenues. So, beginning with coverage, all three companies suggest a very low level of coverage. Again, this is existing financing obligations, so that and these are again estimates of the most recent period. Next, we have the negative cash flow scenario exposure, and FMX comes out quite high in this respect, and that is definitely a concern and needs to be looked into more. The next behind that is Coca-Cola. Next is centrality. Again, now we're moving into cash flow in terms of revenues. And centrality of the cash flows is quite low for FMX, highest for DEO, and fairly good for Coca-Cola. Again, centrality is not the comprehensive assessment of the company's performance, but it gives an idea, but other factors definitely need to be taken into consideration to get the overall picture. So next we move on to the potential financing obligations coverage, which is labeled here as MAE 0.5 and MAE 0.10. Which represents maximum acceptable exposure. So this is financing obligations with those assumptions where there would be exposure limited to either 5% or 10% of the total possible outcomes of cash flows. What we see is that DEO comes out definitely on top in both scenarios, both clearly positive, 9% and 12.5%. For each of these scenarios. And then the others, not for 5%, no, and then just 2%, a little over 2% for Coca-Cola in the 10% scenario. Now, one might ask, well, if the potential financing obligations are so positive for DEO, why is it so low on the coverage end? And again, these are potential based on those MAE exposure assumptions stated, and what's happening is that the debt levels are very high for actually for all the companies relative to revenues. We've got for DEO, for example, 29% of revenues is now taken in financing obligations, which is defined as debt service and dividends. FMX between 11% to 9%. On average in the past few years, and 11% most recently. And Coca-Cola is also has a very high level of existing financing obligations, estimated to be somewhere around over 50% of revenues. And again, that is an estimate, but overall the companies are definitely do have high levels of financing obligations, and this is definitely weighing down on their potential. Thank you very much for listening.